everybody. Welcome back to our channel.
I am excited for today's video. This is a little bit different than what we normally do, but we are going to be watching some TikTok videos and giving you our genuine reaction to them.
As much as we said, like, I'm not the social media person, there's some things on TikTok that just hit my heart.
Like, I would be, like, putting the baby down at night, and I'd come down, and she'd be, like, scrolling through TikTok, and I'd be like, what are you doing? Just not typical for her at all.
TikTok is like the LGBTQ mecca. So,
it really is.
So there's like everything LGBTQ on there. And it's just stuff that you don't see other places. And so you feel more related to, I guess.
Yeah. All right, so we're going to show you the ones we're watching here. And you're going to see your gender reaction here.
Are we ready to get started with this?
I think so. I'm excited.
Yeah, she hasn't quite seen most of these.
No, I don't really do TikTok, guys.
I've actually been the one that's seen them, which is... It's never like that. It's always the other way around. All right, let's start taking a look.
Hey, Mom. I'm a homosexual.
I'm not.
So this one may ruffle some feathers, but I feel like it needs to be said. Why are there no parents asking their teenagers when they come home from school and say that they have a heterosexual crush if they're sure? If they're sure it's not just a phase. Because if your teenager comes home and says they have a crush on somebody of the same sex, why the hell are you asking that question then?
True story.
100%.
Why is it that when little Kyle comes home from a school formal, all proud and telling his daddy that he danced with little Sarah, his daddy don't stop him and go, well, hold on now, son. Are you sure?
It's even better. This is like,
are you sure it's not just a phase?
That's exactly what I was just thinking.
Have you tried penis? You never know. You might like it. Have you tried going out on a date with another little boy? Because if you're not doing that, don't ask a gay kid.
It's 100% true. Like, you don't know until you have experience.
Oh my, oh my, oh my God. This girl straight and this girl not. Tipsy off that piece.
Mom, there's something I want to tell you. Mom,
what?
I'm trans.
Okay. Are you?
Yeah.
Okay. So, what does that mean for us?
I'm a boy.
Okay. All right. So, new name?
Oliver.
Oliver. Okay. We'll talk about this with Dad when we get home. And
uh-huh.
I hope that is how I kind of laugh.
Thank you. Oh, my God. I was so nervous this entire car ride.
Late.
about some of these that I've seen is that people are so nervous.
Because it's hit or miss, you don't know.
Yeah, right.
I mean, some people are lucky enough that they like really do know. So I mean, and in a positive way at least, but you don't. And it's not like this, like this has to happen over and over. Like,
right.
We talk about that all the time. You have to come out over and over and over and over again.
Oh my god, this girl straight and this girl not. Tipsy off that piece of rock.
I just love the reactions of the other person.
Want me to film?
Sure.
Well.
Surprise,
Bye.
You are?
Racial?
No, bisexual.
Is this a joke?
No.
Does it look like she's joking?
Oh, good for you.
Oh, good for you.
Aww.
Oh, Sean, it's so... me, Sean. This is good news.
Aw, Tringles, we love you no matter what.
Aww, I didn't know.
Yep, so. Yeah. My computer was not as cute as some
like
of y'all. I see y'all making little rainbow cakes and I'm gay on it. Little 5-paragraph poems, just explaining it. Like, that's just cute. But you wanna know how I came out? You wanna know? I was at a restaurant with my parents and there was this fine, when I tell you this, fine ass boy at the table across. And I was just eating my food, like, looking back, like, you know, flirting with the eyes a little bit, giving you a little Debbie Ryan look. And I was just looking, and the last time I just a little glance, he got his ass up, walked over to the table, and I was like, oh shit, you doing, bitch. And he comes over, he's like, hey, I thought you were cute, and I just kind of wanted you to get your snap. And I was like, ooh. And I looked at my parents, I was like, I have a decision. I can either risk it all for the dick and come out, or have to turn this fine ass man away. And guess what I did? I got the snap and I came out, period.
Oh, you know what my parents said? They said, good for you.
He was motherfucking king and queen right there, bitch.
Why would you do that?
Do you like him?
Why would you write I'm gay?
Cause I am. Do you love me still?
Okay.
Marie, you're so dumb. Am I supposed to pretend that I didn't know?
So about a year after I came out to my parents as liking women, I came out to them as gay.
It's like parents are just
and
waiting.
A little bit of backstory here. My mom only ever had like two big life rules for me. The first was don't drink anything alcoholic and blue, which is just good life advice. The other is don't date anyone named Eric. I don't know what the Erics of the world did to her, but that was the other rule. So I came out to them. I was like, hey, I know I told you like girls, but I'm not going to be dating guys anymore. Just like not really interested in men. And my mom said, all right, that's totally fine. No Erica's either.
Hey, Grandma.
Yeah.
What's the first thing that made you think I might have been gay?
The first thing?
Yeah.
Honestly?
Yeah.
When I walked in, when you were a little boy, and I walked into the bathroom, and you were in the bathtub, and you had your wiener stuck down between your legs to where it looked like it wasn't there.
That's the first thing?
Yeah.
I can't put this together.
There's so much stress around it. Like, it's such a big deal. That first time,
you don't know, but you just don't.
Thank you.
straight and this girl not. Tipsy off that piece of rock, like.
Jeans so tight,
I can see those chunks. But her friends are so supportive.
Aww. Well, you know, I understand. You know, I love you. Why don't we just tell them together?
Okay. Yeah. About, after this is over.
About us.
Oh.
Yeah, I think it's what? Probably
goosebumps again.
I it's what?
Probably time I let them in on my secret too.
Oh my god,
you're so strong, and I would like to be able to do that too, if that's okay with you.
Wow.
What the fuck?
Well, fuck has a lot to do with it, I guess. Sorry.
Need you, babe.
Can we get lost in this moment?
That's twins. They had to know. No, they had that bond.
Well, they probably knew it each other.
Yeah. Hey, woke up one day.
There's always people that know before.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So about a month ago, I mentioned in my most previous video that my parents were going to be sending me a letter after I made the decision to come out publicly. I got the letter. I am heartbroken that you have resigned yourself to being gay. I hate it for many reasons. I wasn't even sure if I wanted to share this letter with you guys, but I realized that there's probably some of you out there watching who haven't come out yet, and if I sanitize my coming out experience, I'm going to leave you ill-prepared for the obstacles that you might face. I want you without the gay attachments. What I mean by that is, I'm not interested in meeting or even having to deal with that part of your life. You may lose loved ones in this, and it hurts and it sucks, but at the end of the day, if they can't love you as someone who's gay, they never loved you anyway. What they loved was a shadow in their mind that you were never meant to be. I won't accept that you are gay. You are going to be healthiest when you are who you are meant to be. So be proud of who you are, even when it hurts.
100%, be proud of who you are.
Is that all of them?
That's all of them.
Wow, wow, wow.
But it's just to watch them, it's emotional. You don't know what to expect.
No. Even if you think, you know, you have friends and family that support you, it doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to in that time.
Even if they support other people who have come out.
Right.
Doesn't mean they will support you.
Yeah, their own child or their own
yeah.
best friend or whatever.
It just touches my heart. You don't realize what a big deal coming out is, mm-hmm. and like people don't get it.
Right.
They're like, why do you have to come out? Why do you have? Because not everybody is okay with it.
Right.
You know, and
you need to be true to yourself.
We used to start like new jobs or something like that.
It's so anxiety producing because you don't know what's gonna happen. You don't know.
Mm-mm.
you know, your boss could be really anti-LGBT, and then that makes
been
you
there.
Really...
I've been there.
Right, yeah. And it makes it for a really terrible work environment, mm-hmm. because you feel like you have to, like, walk on eggshells all the time, so...
The reality is you shouldn't. And as much as, like, you wish that you were protected in some way, like, you're not always.
Right.
You know, some states here you are, some states you aren't, and...
Other countries.
Right.
I mean, it's illegal.
Right.
Other places you can be thrown in jail or worse. Well, we hope that some of these TikToks made you laugh, maybe cry, maybe... I don't know, think a little bit.
And listen to the end. Be who you are. Be proud of yourself. Whether that's talking about coming out or whatever the situation is, like, discover who you are at your core and be true to that. Because that's what matters, and that's where you're going to find your happiness.
Yep.
We love you guys. We support you for whoever you are.
We are a safe place for you. So if you need somebody to come out to, send us a message. You're always there. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. And we'll see you guys later.
We'll see you in our next video.
Bye.
Bye.